Inside, need more sevens and you can set them up. Start throwing more of those.
Cool mouthpiece, man.
Thanks.
Yeah. So you just sparred an Olympian, man. How do you feel about your sparring? It looked like he caught you with a nice right hand there towards the end, man. He rocked
yeah,
you.
Yeah, he did. No, he didn't rock me, but it was a good shot. It was a really good shot. My legs weren't hurt or anything, nothing like that. But the guy's good. He knows how to move on the inside. I think I got him more on the outside, but that's why he's always putting that constant pressure. He's smart, he has Joe in his corner, he's got a lot of experience. Joe's got a lot of experience, so does the fighter. And it showed, he's pretty good. I'm glad to be learning from them.
So you're with the Rock Nation, and
yes, sir.
I hear you're part of now of the Dan Goosen stable, right?
Yes, I'm currently about to start with them, so we're gonna go to lunch after this. And
how is that experience, man? Great trainer there, legendary trainer right there.
Yeah, it's really cool. I've never been around somebody around his caliber, and his fighters are only some of the best in the world. So
I know you saw Andre Berto in here putting in work.
Yeah, I saw him.
It's
inspiring.
Keep an eye on him, see what he's doing.
Yeah, exactly. I always try to absorb as much as I can around the fighters around me. The guy's sparring me, he's got great inside work. I gotta pick up on that, learn how to do that a little better.
Daniel Twitch Franco, man, where did the Twitch come from? What was behind that Twitch?
Twitch was when I was an amateur. I was squaring up a lot, when I was first starting. So my dad told me, he was my trainer at the time, told me to check my chin, make sure my chin's in the right spot. So I always do this to make sure it's in the right spot.
People
thought I got a nervous switch or something.
Yeah.
It was cool. I like the name. It goes well. We got t-shirts and stuff. Yeah.
Where can the fans buy the t-shirts?
They can go to warzoneboxclub.com. We'll have them up within the next couple weeks.
All right, now, big fight man, Matthysse CREDIT. A lot of people are calling Matthysse a quitter. Is there any resemblance to that, to what Ortiz did with Maidana?
That was when he broke his jaw, right, Ortiz?
Yeah.
Yeah, his jaw was crazy messed up. He should have kept on fighting and waited until the...
It was his eye.
It was his eye?
He lost his vision temporarily.
That's tough. That's tough when you lose your vision. It's trying to fight with one eye. There's no one-eyed boxers out there. So I give him credit for pushing on as far as he can. Ortiz and Matthysse. Matthysse quit last round, but he's a warrior. I think he was saving himself for maybe... He's got to go another couple.
Mayweather, 49-0, he's officially retired. Where do you see him as all-time greats?
I thought that he should go to 50, at least one more.
Well, I'll be
I'm waiting for that.
Come back,
I'm waiting for that. I'm waiting for him to come back. No, one more.
Who would you like to see him face when he comes down to 50?
I think Amir Khan.
Give him
a good match. But I was thinking that until I seen Khan fight Algeri.
Yeah.
And then Algeri kind of gave him a hard time.
Yeah, yeah. He landed some big shots there. He's not the biggest puncher either.
Khan's got no chin either.
Yeah.
I don't know. I never punched him, but from what I've seen, he doesn't really have too much of a Mexican chin,
All right, for your fans, man, let them know what they can expect from you. Quick message and tell them where to follow you.
You can follow me at Twitter, Instagram, at Daniel Twitch. Also on Facebook, search up Daniel Twitch Franco. And you can catch up on my videos on YouTube, also Daniel Franco. Or you can look up Twitch Boxing. I also have some videos on there. Stay tuned. I want to be the world champion.